So I have had a ton of requests over the years to give a tour of my home network. Not only are computers and technology my day job, but they're also a big part of my hobbyist adventures, in addition to making things in the workshop. Let's start outside of the demarcation point. I get my internet service from Frontier Communications. They recently bought out Verizon Fios in Texas, so this is basically the same service as Verizon offers in other states. My ONT, or optical network terminal, is connected using the copper port via gigabit Ethernet. I currently have my service provisioned as 150 megabit symmetrical, though they do offer up to 500 megabit. I'm just not willing to pay their outrageous prices for it. It's a shame because just two streets away, AT&T is offering gigabit services for less than I pay these guys for 150 megabit. When we built our home, we had the builder create a dedicated closet for the theater room's AV gear and my home network gear. I've never really been happy with the panel they put in the house, and at some point I will probably eliminate it and put in a real patch panel, but for now, this has to suffice. Over here on the right is my main network gear. It's just a little wall mount rack I got from Amazon. In fact, I'll put a link in the description and on my website to where I bought all of this gear if you're interested. The firewall I'm using is a little 6-port unit that I personally imported from China. It's something I am actually considering importing in bulk and selling on my website. It has 6 gigabit ports and I'm currently using pfSense on it. Below that is a 24-port managed switch that I use as my main distribution switch. Under that is a 50-port managed switch that supports PoE or Power over Ethernet. This switch runs all of the cameras for my NVR, which is a little Synology NVR216 that just sits on top of the rack. I do have a whole video on installing this rack if you're interested. And down below that I have 2 triplight UPSs. These maintain power to everything during a power failure. With my load, they will run everything in the network closet for a little over an hour. Over to the left is where I keep my server equipment. I have a Synology RS2416 Plus running 10 3TB Western Digital 7200 RPM drives, and fronted by 2 mirrored 250GB Samsung Evo 850 SSDs for caching. These cache drives make an incredible difference in performance since my servers are running ESXi and the operating systems live on the NAS. Speaking of servers, these other two boxes act as my servers. They are the 1U servers from a previous video, but I moved them into 2U cases because I needed more PCI slots for another project I was doing. In fact, I still have the 1U cases here in storage, which I'll probably build into a lab box at some point. These have server VMs that run lots of different things in my home. I'm running HomeSeer for home automation, Plex for video serving and live TV distribution, Observium for network monitoring, and several other things. And yes, I am legally licensed for all of this stuff. Back over here on top of the network rack is one more device. This is an HD Home Run Extend. You plug an aerial antenna into it and then plug it into your Ethernet network. Then, using a number of different software packages, you can distribute broadcast TV around the home without a need to run antenna cables to all of your TVs. There are apps for almost any device, such as Apple TV, Xbox, or smartphones. However, I simply have my Plex Media Server distribute the video over the Plex app. It's simple and it works flawlessly. Up here above my servers is a ZNet from HomeSeer. This device broadcasts the Z-Wave protocol throughout my home, which controls my Z-Wave switches and other devices for home automation. I really like this device because it allows me to run HomeSeer in a virtual machine and move it between servers without the need to move a physical USB stick to the other physical box. The last thing I'll point out about my network closet is that it has a dedicated exhaust fan connecting to the return side of my home air conditioning unit. This fan is always exhausting air from the room, even when the AC is not running. This keeps the room at a comfortable temperature. I have a lot of info on this setup on my website at thegeekpub.com. This is my office where I do most of my videos and stuff. I'm running a Mac Pro I got on Craigslist that I run Final Cut Pro 10 for. Although I have to say I'm seriously considering switching back to a Windows PC with Adobe Premiere since Apple seems to be going a different direction with the Pro stuff. Connected to my Mac Pro is a Drobo 5D that I use mainly for holding backups of my older video footage. It's connected via Thunderbolt. On top of my Drobo is an external DVD drive and a USB 3 Samsung T3 SSD drive, which I use as my scratch disk for video editing. It's connected to a Samsung 28-inch 4K monitor. Behind my desk is a test PC and a Gigabyte Bricks running Chrome in full screen. This shows stats from Observium for my servers, networks, and internet usage. You can see that it shows the temperature as well. Over to the left of that, I have the Packade that I built in a previous video that is powered by a Raspberry Pi 3. This gets a lot of use and is something I tremendously enjoy having in my office. Down here on the floor is my little lab rack. This was sent to me by Rosewill. I have plans for this little guy in an upcoming video. For now, I am just running my lab switch in it, which is powering a PoE camera that is watching our pool be built. Now that's a project I can't wait to be complete. Of course, these aren't really on my network, but this is where I'm starting the build out of my 8-bit computer museum. If someone wants to send me an Altair 8800, feel free. The game room is where I keep the full-size arcade cabinet I built in a previous video. This thing is always a huge hit when we have parties or guests stay with us. In the middle of the room is our gaming rig. I built this rig with my son a year or so ago. It's running an ASUS Z170 programming motherboard, an Intel Skylake i7 6700K processor, 16GB of RAM, and a GeForce GTX 1080 video card. Some of you have probably already noticed that we're also rocking an Oculus Rift. I am a huge fan of virtual reality. For those of you who think it's a fad like 3D TV was, I challenge you to try the Oculus or the HTC Vive. That stuff you put your smartphone in isn't even close to this experience. Lastly, this is where we have our gaming area set up. We only have the Xbox One running right now, but at some point I do hope to add a next generation PlayStation to the mix. This is the Xbox One Day One Edition. Placed strategically throughout the house in various locations, I keep Apple AirPort Extremes. I like these because they can be picked up really cheap and they just work. They never crash and the performance is excellent. In addition, they support a feature called Guest Networking, which works over VLAN 1003. This allows me to offer internet access to all of my guests without giving them access to my home network. I have a whole article on my website on how to make this work without using an Apple router for your internet connection. Now, I'm a big believer in security and surveillance, and while I won't show you everything in this video, I will show you a little of it. Strategically placed around the house, you will find a myriad of surveillance cameras. My favorite cameras are the Axis cameras. The picture is phenomenal, and they never have problems, but they're not cheap. These cameras are all connected via Ethernet back to the PoE switch in my network closet, meaning they are hardwired and powered by Ethernet. For security reasons, all of these cameras are on a private VLAN that has no access to my home. This prevents an intruder from accessing my home network by jacking in externally. My Synology is connected to Amazon Drive and syncs all of the video footage to Amazon in case of a fire or robbery, where they actually steal the Synology recorder. Lastly, in addition to all these regular alarm pads on the walls, we have electronic keypads on the exterior doors. These keypads interface with a home automation system and alarm for granting access to the home. This allows us to do some really neat stuff, like restrict maids' access to a certain day or a certain set of hours. This can help prevent a burglary by service company personnel when we are out of town or on a day they wouldn't normally be here. Hey Siri, turn on the wine cellar light.
Okay, the wine cellar light is on.
The last thing I'll show you is our home automation setup. I won't spend a lot of time on this because I already have a video on how to set this up. Using HomeSear, I have various bridge software in place that bridges HomeSear into other devices. Anything in the home can be controlled by Siri on an Apple device or by Alexa. Speaking of Alexa, I have a few of them around the house at strategic locations. In the kitchen, which is sort of central to the house, but also on the nightstand in the master bedroom. For controlling my theater room and living room devices, I used Harmony Hubs. These devices are so simple to set up and make it a breeze to connect to Alexa, Siri, and HomeSear. If I want to change the volume, just ask Alexa or Siri. If I want to change the channel or play a certain song, I just ask Alexa or Siri. It's so awesome and simple. Well, hey guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Now, there's a whole lot of different ways that you could do this. You could use much higher end gear, Cisco gear, Control 4, and all of those. Those get very expensive. And I'm sure there's going to be a lot of you that are going to tell me how wrong I did it, and that's okay. Go ahead and drop a comment below and tell me how you would do it. See you in the next video.